Hello friends, I hope you liked my fourth video, that is about what are the different life cycle phases to validate a computerized system as per ISB guidelines. If you are having any question, you can ask me in the comment. So in this video, we will discuss about the user requirement specification. My YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality, so please view, like, comment and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the Pharma Quality standard and practices. Now we will discuss what is user requirement specification. User requirement specification provides the knowledge of basic user requirements to manufacturer about the software and hardware. I would like to give an example from the quality laboratory. So let's say if you are planning to procure a SPECIFICATION instrument with software, then you need to elaborate about the basic requirement, that is how the instrument perform the chromatographic analysis and software acquire the data for processing and reporting. So it is written by the system owner and end user with input from the quality assurance. Actually they know the concept and having the technical knowledge about the system, hence their inputs are very important to have a impactful URS. So once the URS is ready, then it is provided to the manufacturer to brief about what are the minimum requirements of user, and further based on the URS, manufacturer are going to be ready your system. Now in this slide we will discuss about the general guideline to write an effective URS. So first point is requirement must not be repeated or contradictory. So it is very important that when you are writing a URS, each point should be identified and have the clear instruction. So next point is each requirement should be testable, verifiable. So whatever the requirement mentioned in the URS should be based on the technical knowledge only. Hence, it is very important to write a URS by taking the input from the end user. It may be your analyst or operator, and then peer review process should be followed to identify any error. Next one is the URS should define the business requirement, operation and regulatory requirements. That is about the core technical requirement, that is how to operate the system with related to security, control, IT control or 21 CFR related requirements. Discuss about the practical approach to write a URS. So first point is purpose. So describe in the purpose that what is the goal of the URS to define the requirements, such as what kind of operation, function, regulatory and performance requirement are expected from that system. Next is the scope. In the scope, describe where it will be applicable with respect to the system or location. For example, if the system will be used in a particular department, then specify the location. Next is system overview. So here you need to describe about the details of required system. For example, if you are procuring SPECIFICATION and software, then you need to elaborate about the different modules of the SPECIFICATION and use of system, like analysis of raw material or finished product samples. Also define how the system will control by the software. Define how the data collection will be done. Also define how the data transfer to the server. Define what are the expectations related to the report, and also define how the online calculation will be done, and also define how the data will be acquired if network failure observed. So I gave the example based on the practical knowledge. So if any other system required to write an URS, elaborate about that particular system details. So next is operation requirement. So here you need to describe the main functionality regarding the supported processes and analysis, including modes and ranges of operation, accuracy and precision requirements, also the performance requirement and about the system capacity and response, etc. Next is functional requirements. Here you need to describe about the functionality of the system. For example, sequence and method preparation, sequence execution, integration of data, reporting of results. So, you know, actually there are many technical functionalities required for a computerized system. So it is recommended to address the all requirement based on the system complexity and regulatory requirements. So next is technical requirement, such as security of system, access control for different level of users, audit trail, use of electronic signatures, report formats, unambiguous error message, that is any error message that should have the clear instructions or notes. Next is basic technical requirement. So you specify the basic requirement from the manufacturer, like basic layout of the equipment, common installation layout of the equipment, list of all components including material description, total weight and capacity. So next is change over parts requirements. So specify the consumables or parts which are required to change in routine operation. Also, if there is any other specific requirements, so do mention the other specific requirement if it is applicable. Next is environment requirement. So physical layout should be defined where instrument or equipment shall be placed. Physical condition, that is temperature and relative humidity or any other required condition, that should also be defined. Next is power requirement in terms of voltage, earthing, UPS, that is uninterrupted power supply, should also be defined. Any other physical or logical requirement are identified, then it should also be defined. So next is regulatory requirement. So 21 CFR Part 11 requirement should be defined, that is related to electronic record and electronic signature. IT related controls should also be defined, such as cut, copy, paste, delete, move, etc. That should be defined to control. Any SS level control for data integrity should also be defined, that is unauthorized user cannot be able to access that system. So next is safety requirement. So requirement of emergency stop, alarm or any indication should be defined. Requirement of personal safety such as electrical wiring must be consulted. Warning sticker on hot surfaces should be labeled. Requirement related to power failure and power recovery should also be defined. Pharmacopoeia requirement. If any pharmacopoeia chapter requirement is needed, then it should be defined. Next one is the documentation. Specify the required documentation support from the supplier that may include DQ, IQ, OQPQ or any other deliverables, test scripts, etc. Next is training. So specify the training requirement of technical staff, that is detailed practical and theoretical knowledge and training should be provided to the end users. So friends, this is all about the user requirement specification, and in the next video we will discuss about the vendor assessment, or it is called the vendor audit. I hope this video will help you better understand to how to write a URS. Thank you.